Hello, my name is Grigore Roșu and I'm a professor of computer science at University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign and also the president and CEO of Runtime Verification, a startup company that does research and development in formal semantics, specification and verification of programming languages and software. Until we started our collaboration with IOHK last summer, we have mostly developed technologies to be used in the context of mission and safety critical systems with funding from the NSF, NASA, Boeing, DARPA, Toyota, Denso, and so on. But now, thanks to IOHK's enthusiasm and support to develop new research and technologies for the blockchain, we have become quite interested in extending the applicability of our techniques and tools into this exciting area. The projects that we are collaborating on with IOHK are related to the formal design and development of virtual machines and languages for the blockchain. A bit of context first. Jointly with my UIUC students and many collaborators, we have developed a semantic framework for defining programming languages and virtual machines in a mathematically very rigorous way, which we call the K framework. Once you define a language or a VM in K, the framework gives you a suite of tools for it, such as parsers, interpreters, compilers, state explorers, model checkers, and even deductive program verifiers. Of crucial importance, these tools are all correct by construction. There are several attempts by other programming languages and formal methods groups to develop such frameworks, but K is the first that demonstrated that this is indeed possible and feasible. Indeed, we and others have formalized in K real-life languages like C, Java, JavaScript, Python, and PHP, and the tools that K generates automatically from these language semantics are comparable in features and performance with existing tools specifically crafted for such languages. The 15 years of research and development work on K have made it possible to do what many thought couldn't be done. We can automatically generate a correct by construction virtual machine from its formal specification, which is fast enough to run real programs. And we have done it twice. First, for the Ethereum virtual machine, EVM, as part of the K-EVM project, and second, for a new VM called YELE. So what is K-EVM? K-EVM is a correct by construction Ethereum client based on the most prominent formal mathematical specification of the EVM. The formal specification of the EVM has been developed using the K framework in a joint effort with my research lab at UIUC, the Formal System Laboratory. Besides generating an executable VM, the K formal EVM specification can also be used as is for formal verification of smart contracts. We are grateful to IOHK for funding the K-EVM project and for their firm belief in the generation of correct by construction VMs from formal specifications. Sounds like a dream, but not anymore. In a collaborative effort with IOHK, K-EVM will be deployed on a testnet soon, before YELE. K-EVM will be deployed first because the fact that it is built on top of an already established language and test infrastructure means that it will be more quickly brought up to professional industrial quality. This will also allow us to test and mature the network and communication infrastructure, which will also be used by YELE. The plan is to refine the network and communication infrastructure to a point where we can simply plug and play a new VM. Now, what is YELE? In a nutshell, YELE is a human-readable blockchain low-level language meant to serve as a foundation for the third generation of blockchains. We are currently working on deploying it on the Cardano blockchain together with a wonderful team of experts at IOHK. YELE was designed using state-of-the-art formal methods to address security and correctness concerns in Ethereum, while simultaneously enabling the similar mathematically rigorous formal proofs of smart contract correctness that K-EVM brings to Ethereum. Let me elaborate a bit. People often craft formal specifications for languages so they can find weaknesses in these languages. So it is not surprising that when we wrote our formal specification for EVM, it showed us ways to improve it. We use that knowledge to design YELE. YELE is therefore the next step in the evolution of our correct by construction, automatically generated implementation concept. It was completely designed and defined as a formal semantics, and the executable code was generated automatically from the formal specification. So there is nothing to prove about the correctness of the YELE VM with respect to its formal specification, because it is correct by construction. ELE offers improved security guarantees over and above what EVM provides, making it easier to write contracts which do not leak or lack funds. Inspired from both LLVM and EVM, ELE is built to become the foundation of an entire compiler backend pipeline, eventually allowing robust gas optimization and bytecode of contracts written in any high-level language which has ELE as a compilation target, including Solidity and Plutus. The plan is to deploy ELE on the Cardano blockchain in a few months, so we are very busy testing it and developing a little ecosystem of tools around it. Is it easy to write or read ELE programs? The ELE language uses an LLVM style textual representation that is designed to be human readable and at the same time to capture all the available ELE features. It is pretty easy to even manually write smart contracts straight in ELE. For example, we manually wrote an ERC20 token in only a couple of hours. It has about 150 lines of ELE code, each function is clearly visible, and it is quite easy to map the ERC20 specification to the ELE code. But we are going to also provide a Solidity compiler to ELE, so one can execute existing smart contracts written in Solidity that are so far only executing on Ethereum, or new contracts to test the capabilities of ELE. Will the Solidity compiler to ELE generate more secure code than on EVM? The Solidity to ELE compiler takes advantage of the strong security guarantees offered by ELE to generate more secure code than its EVM counterpart. Additionally, the compiler is designed to facilitate easy inclusion of static analysis and optimization passes, same like LLVM, that will hopefully also increase security. Are all the Solidity features going to be supported right away? The Solidity to ELE compiler will support all Solidity features that aren't exposing low-level EVM functionality. Features like inline EVM assembly and low-level API exposing calls will not be supported as they aren't meaningful for ELE backend. Features like delegate call that are known to introduce security concerns in EVM are also excluded, since ELE provides safer alternatives. What is the role of the forthcoming K-EVM and ELE testnets? So the testnets are designed to allow developers to experiment with K-EVM and ELE in a production-like environment, to write and deploy their production smart contracts and test that they provide the functionality expected of them without bugs or security vulnerabilities. Users can use K-EVM and ELE to compare the relative performance of a smart contract on both EVM and ELE, but by compiling the same Solidity code to both targets, running it on both chain and seeing for themselves which one is faster or uses less gas. But the ultimate goal is to get the ELEVM ready for deployment on the Cardano blockchain. This is the first time a formally, semantically defined and completely automatically generated VM is used in production. So it is a huge step for the entire formal methods community. Your help, support, feedback, and criticisms are immensely useful. What to expect from K-EVM and ELE in terms of performance? So first, recall that these VMs are automatically generated from their formal specifications, a fact which introduces some performance penalty over and above existing Ethereum clients. We are in the process of generating a new compiler for K, which is intended to be at least as fast as the human written interpreters in existing Ethereum clients, but it will not be ready until the full production launch. Developers should still expect the performance of K-EVM to be tolerable and report excessive performance penalties, for example, stalling indefinitely on a transaction and so on. So please report such excessive performance penalties to developers as bugs to be fixed, because the performance is intended to only be within a single order of magnitude slower. ELE, on the other hand, has been designed also with performance in mind, so we do not expect any major performance glitches with ELE.